Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Johnson. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Monday, the 8th of February. India's Prime Minister Modi urges farmers to give chance to agriculture reforms, assures MSP to stay. Police bait and charge vendors protesting anti-encroachment drive in Pakistan-administered Kashmir. And American troops will not leave Afghanistan in May, says US Senator Graham. And now for all the details. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Monday urged protesting farmers from the parliament to end the agitation against new farm laws, assuring them that the mechanism of MSP, minimum support price for key crops, would remain in place. Farmer leaders, however, said they want a law on MSP, not just assurances.
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Monday urged farmers to end their over 2 months long protest against three new agriculture reforms while assuring them from the parliament that a mechanism of floor prices for key crops would remain in place. Thousands of farmers camping at capital New Delhi's border since last November fear the laws will leave them at the mercy of big corporate buyers, gradually ending the current practice of assured government purchases at minimum support price or MSP. Modi extended invitation to farmer leaders for talks once again to resolve the impasse and assured that MSP was there, is there and will remain in the future as well.
मैं विश्वास दिलाता हूं कि मंडियां अधिक आधुनिक बने, अधिक प्रतिस्पर्धी होगी। इस बार बजट में भी उसके लिए हमने प्रावधान किया है। इतना ही नहीं, एमएसपी है, एमएसपी था, एमएसपी रहेगा।
Meanwhile, prominent farmer leader Rakesh Tikait termed Prime Minister Modi's statement an attempt to confuse. He said they are ready to talk, but farmers do not just want assurance, but a law on MSP.
अरे बे उड़ जा रे। हमने कहा कहा कि MSP खत्म हो रहा। हमने ये कहा कि MSP पे कानून बने। MSP पे कानून बन जाएगा, तो देश के किसानों को फायदा होगा। अब MSP पे कानून नहीं है, तो व्यापारी आधे में लूटता है उसको।
The federal government has offered concessions to the farmers but has refused to repeal the three laws, arguing that they are crucial to bring new investment to the agriculture sector, which accounts for nearly 15% of India's $2.9 trillion economy and about half its workforce.
The glacier burst in India's northern Uttarakhand state has caused severe devastation after it triggered massive flooding in Dhauli Ganga and Alaknanda rivers on Sunday, leaving over 10 people dead and 192 missing, who are feared dead. An operation to rescue people trapped in a tunnel near the Tapovan Dam continued on Monday, and heavy machinery were used to clear the debris.
Rescuers were looking for at least 192 people missing in the Indian Himalayas in northern Uttarakhand state on Monday, including some trapped in a tunnel after a part of a glacier broke away, sending a torrent of water, rock and dust down a mountain valley, according to local officials. Sunday's violent surge below Nanda Devi, India's second highest peak, swept away a small hydroelectric project called Rishi Ganga and damaged a bigger one further downstream, the Dhauli Ganga River, being built by state firm NTPC. Rescue squads were focused on drilling their way through a 2.5-kilometer long tunnel at the Tapovan Vishnugarh Hydropower Project site that NTPC was building 5 kilometers downstream, where about 30 workers were believed trapped.
अभी ये वाला जो बड़ा वाला टनल है इसको अब 70-80 मीटर खोला गया है बहुत ज़्यादा कल मलबा अंदर आ गई थी तो पूरा ब्लॉकेड हो गई है तो उसी को दोनों जो जेसीबी है वो अंदर जाके निकाल रहे हैं और 100 करीब 180 मीटर का टनल है और एक आउटलेट टनल है जहाँ से हाँ जो 30 से 40 वर्कर्स हैं फंसे हुए हैं कल से, तो उनको निकालने का प्रयास है।
It was not immediately clear what had set off the avalanche at this time of the year, with freezing temperatures and no rain.
The search for renowned Pakistani mountaineer Muhammad Ali Satpara and his two fellow climbers entered the third day on Monday as harsh weather continued to hamper search and rescue efforts. The climbers had gone missing as they were getting close to the summit of K2 on Friday. At that time, they were crossing the treacherous bottleneck. An aerial search to find three experienced climbers, renowned Pakistani climber Muhammad Ali Satpara, John Snorri from Iceland and Jean Pablo Moore from Chile, who lost contact with base camp during a winter ascent of K2, the world's second highest mountain, resumed on Monday morning. The climbers had gone missing as they were getting close to the summit of K2 on Friday. The team lost contact with base camp late on Friday. Sajid Ali Satpara, son of missing Pakistani climber, said on Sunday that the chances of finding his father alive are next to none.
मेरे ख्याल में ऑपरेशन अगर बॉडी की सर्चिंग के लिए ऑपरेशन हो तो ठीक है, बाकी उनके जो बचने के जो चांसेस है, अगर 8000 पे विंटर में बंदा दो तीन दिन से पट है तो जिंदा बचने की चांसेस ना होने के बराबर है.
Sajid suggested that the three climbers were probably involved in an accident while descending from the K2 bottleneck, considered the most dangerous route of the entire expedition and sometimes referred to as killer mountain. Last month, a team of 10 Nepali climbers became the first ever to climb to its summit in winter. Moving on, scores of street vendors were mercilessly beaten as they protested against what they called forcible eviction in the name of anti-garbage and anti-encroachment drive in Pakistan-administered Kashmir recently. They expressed anger and dismay over the harassment by the authorities in the illegally occupied region at the behest of Islamabad.
Protesting against what they term harassment of street vendors and their forcible eviction, scores of street vendors held a protest as authorities were holding an anti-garbage and anti-encroachment drive in Muzaffarabad city of Pakistan-administered Kashmir recently. Local municipality officials at the site said illegal encroachments on footpaths and streets had been obstructing the flow of traffic. The protesters described the move as inhumane and expressed dismay over demolition of their sources of earning, as their vegetable and fruit items were also picked up using a crane and burnt along with piles of garbage. But the police accompanying the municipality officials soon after foiled their bid to even protest and mercilessly beat and charged upon them. The vendors blamed they face constant threats and exploitation at the hands of authorities in the illegally occupied region that work at the behest of Islamabad, who have now even snatched their right to earn a living.
In news from Afghanistan, Republican U.S. Senator Lindsey Graham has said that the American troops will not leave Afghanistan in May, supporting the Biden administration's stance on Afghanistan and its bid to review the U.S.-Taliban agreement. Graham, accusing the Taliban of cheating, said the troops will leave when the conditions are right.
Republican U.S. Senator Lindsey Graham, in an interview with CBS, has said that the American troops will not leave Afghanistan in May, supporting the Biden administration's stance on Afghanistan and its bid to review the U.S.-Taliban agreement. In response to a question that will the U.S. troops leave Afghanistan post-May, Graham said he thinks the troops are not going to leave in May. Accusing Taliban of cheating, he said the troops will leave when the conditions are right. This comes as NATO Secretary General Jens Stoltenberg last week expressed concern over terror attacks against individuals, journalists and others in Afghanistan. He said NATO and its allies are finding it difficult to decide on the war-torn country right now. According to the US Taliban agreement signed in February last year, the troops were to leave Afghanistan by May 2021 in exchange of peace guarantees. However, Washington has accused the militant group of increasing targeted killings in Afghanistan.
More news from Afghanistan. India on Sunday handed over 500,000 doses of COVID-19 vaccines to Afghan official as its gift to the people of the War Torn Nation, as part of a program by New Delhi to distribute the vaccine to its neighbors. The India-made vaccine is the first to reach Afghanistan as the country battles the pandemic.
Afghanistan received 500,000 doses of AstraZeneca's COVID-19 vaccine from India on Sunday. The first to arrive in the country, which is still waiting for emergency approval from the World Health Organization before it can use them. Ghulam Dastagir Nazari, head of the immunization program at the Health Ministry, said the doses would be stored in Kabul until the emergency authorization was received, which it hoped would happen in a week. Waheed Majro, the Afghan acting minister of health, said that they are trying to provide vaccines for the 60% of Afghan population and it will be done gradually. Afghanistan has so far witnessed 55,359 COVID-19 cases, leading to 2,413 deaths.
Based on the National Vaccine Deployment Plan, we will be trying to cover 60% of our population. It will be done gradually, and we're working with different partners, including USAID, the World Bank, Islamic Development Bank, Asian Development Bank, the European Union, and our neighboring countries like India, China, to ensure that our people are provided with the required number of vaccines.
Good times and bad, India and Afghanistan have stayed together, and we call it as a vaccine maitri, which is, you know, friendship through vaccination.
India is one of the world's biggest drug makers, and an increasing number of countries have already approached it for procuring the coronavirus vaccines. India has authorized two vaccines for emergency use at home, Covishield and Covaxin.
Moving on to news from Sri Lanka. Sri Lanka has given a contract to a Chinese company to set up $12 million hybrid wind and solar energy projects on its three island of the northern Jaffna Peninsula, around 30 miles from India's southern coastal town of Rameshwaram. According to local media reports, the contract to the Chinese company Sinosar E-Tech Wind was approved by the Cabinet Standing Committee on Procurement on July 18, before Sri Lanka's cancellation of an agreement with India and Japan on the development and operation of Eastern Container Terminal at Colombo Port. This has provoked a strong protest from India, as such a move would raise security concerns for the neighbouring country. The islands concerned are the Delft Island, Analathivu and Nainathivu, separated by the Park Strait from India, which are in close proximity to India's coast. After winning the Global Pageant for Mrs. Queen of India 2020, Aruna Patil wants to encourage all the married women like her to follow their dreams. Patil, who has set an example for many in India, has said the life of married women does not end after marriage and they can still showcase their talents at various platforms.
The newly crowned Global Pageant Mrs. Queen of India 2020, Aruna Patil, has said that the life of married women does not end after marriage and they can still showcase their talents at various platforms. Over 30 married women from across India participated in the Global Pageant Mrs. Queen of India 2020, organized by Delhi-based Edward Global Media and Creation Media Organization. Aruna Patil was crowned the winner of the pageant, while Monica Singh and Mansimran Sahani were first and second runner-ups respectively.
I just want to say that life is not over after marriage. There are so many opportunities and so many platforms like this that where you can showcase your talents and be good at what you are. That's the message I want to give to all the women, all the misses of our Indias.
Organizers said such beauty contests can also inspire married women of diverse backgrounds and cultures to come together nationally and internationally to showcase their strength, beauty and hidden potential.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now, our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/asianewsline and follow us on Twitter @asianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.